the first of two conversations I'm going to have with Lýdia Machová. Hello, Lýdia.
Hi, everyone.
Nice to be with you. We're actually in Tenerife here, don't get too jealous. But yeah, I'm having quite a bit of travelling in my life at the moment. I'll be back in London for 3 weeks, and then I'm off over to Bratislava to the Polyglot Gathering. If you're a regular on the site and you follow my vlogs, you'll know that I've reviewed and vlogged from this event several times before. And Lýdia is actually the head organiser of the event this year, as she was last year. So it's great to have her here. What actually is the Polyglot Gathering?
It's basically a meetup of people who love languages. And maybe the name is a bit misleading, because it sounds like you need to be a polyglot to get in there. But actually, we have people who just really love learning languages, and it doesn't matter at all how many languages you speak.
But you need to be a language genius, or?
No, not at all. We have a lot of people who maybe are learning one or two foreign languages. Maybe they struggle with a few, but generally they're interested in them. And I think this is what unites us and makes the whole event very interesting.
So it's a festival of enthusiasts for languages.
Exactly.
Right?
And maybe that would be a better name. Maybe. Sound so better to you.
Yeah. So, I mean, previously it's been a four-day format with most of the presentations in English, big talks and smaller workshops. Is it the same this year?
Yeah, we're making it 5 days now, with the first day, with a few trips before the gathering, so you can come to Bratislava and get to know the city on our city walking tour and some other events. And also we're having more talks in other than English, other languages than English, and also some non-language related workshops. Because we realized that basically what these people come to for the Polyglot Gathering is having fun with other people, not necessarily learning something about languages.
Yeah. So what sort of topics would they be?
Yeah, there will be workshops, for example, on origami or, you know, a salsa workshop.
Oh, really? So quite moving away from...
Very language-y. Yes.
Yeah. Okay. And so people would come, book their own accommodation, and they can come for 1 or 2 days or the whole lot.
Exactly. You can pick how many days you would like to stay.
And then you take part as much as you want.
I think the best thing about it, I think you will agree with me, is actually meeting all these cool people.
Yes. Yeah.
And it's so easy to make friends at the gathering because everybody's super open, friendly. People usually go for a lunch or dinner together somewhere downtown, and we're just having a great time together.
And I remember I was actually, you know, I was nervous to go to the first one because I thought, I'm not a polyglot, I'm not a great, you know, some sort of language genius. I'm just doing some things, I think, which anybody can do to make progress. But I thought, you know, and I didn't know anybody the first time I went to one. But each year one finds new people coming for the first time. And it's a big enough event that everybody can fit in and everybody's super open and interested in communication and getting to know people. Otherwise, they wouldn't be keen on languages. Great. So can you tell us the dates again this year? Yeah.
So this year, 2018, it's going to be from the May 30th. To June 3rd.
Okay, so 30th of May to June the 3rd. I'll put the link underneath, have a look. If you've got any questions, hit them down in the comments below, or, you know, let me know, and I'll get back to you. Thanks a lot for watching. Don't forget to share this video, hit the like button, and subscribe to the channel if you haven't done already, and see you next time. How do we say goodbye then in Slovak?
We say
dovidenia. Dovidenia.